In the first chapter of my book, part 1, therefore in case of English portion, we come across the use of alphabet letters. Therefore, as in the previous classes, we learned that the smaller alphabetically ordered, the alphabetically alphabets, that is A, B, C, D, etc., written in either in smaller form as well as in capital form. But the use of capital letters have some specific rules where we can use them. According to that, we need to follow, as well as in case of writing, as well as in case of reading also, we need to take care that where the capital letters are used. Therefore, some of the basic rules for using capital letters while writing are: so three rules are there: that beginning word of a sentence, use of I, and the names of person, place, newspaper, river, and monuments. First, I am going through, that is the beginning of a word of a sentence, that is three sentences there: Anik is my friend, mango tastes sweet, and we love to eat chicken curry. In every sentence, the beginning word, that is Anik, mango, we, and the beginning letter begins with a higher case, that is in capital order. Therefore, we need to focus and keep in mind that the beginning of a word of a sentence usually takes the capital letter, its initial word. So, we need to focus on that. Next. three sentences there. I am a student. She and I go to the market every day, and he knows that I am a cricketer. In all the three sentences, the word I, irrespective of their positions. In the first sentence, I comes generally in the first, as the first letter is begins with a capital, therefore I begins with a capital word. But in the second sentence, I is comes in the middle of the sentence. After the two word, initial two words, I is used. But as I is used single-handedly, and it is always used in the higher case, that is in capital form. And in the third line also, that the two sentences are joined by a clause, but even in that case, I is used in a higher case. Therefore, we need that the rule, we always need to maintain the rule that whenever you use I, whether it is used at the beginning of the sentence or at the end of the sentence, it will be always a higher case. And the third one, that is the point, that is the names of rivers, person and place, newspaper, etc., we use the capital letters. That is the first of the example, that is Ganga is a holy river. Ganga being a river as well as the name, it begins with a higher, that is higher case, that is the capital letters. In the second sentence, I know Sumit very well. Sumit, a name of a person, that is boy, and he is very known to me. Therefore, that beginning of the sentence is not their word, but it is in the middle of the sentence. In spite of that, as it is a name of a person, it begins with a capital letter. In the third sentence, that is I live in Bardwan. Bardwan, that is our hometown, and it's a name of a place, and it also begins with the higher case, that is the capital letter. And in the last one, I have given an example of a newspaper that I generally read every day. I read the Statesman every day. But here, as the Statesman is the name of a daily newspaper, it begins with a higher case. So the three basic points that we need to follow while we are using the capital letters. First is the beginning word of every sentence, that is begins with a capital letter. Second is the use of I, whenever we use I in the middle of the sentence or in the beginning of the sentence or at the last part of the end part of a sentence, we always use it in capital letter. And in third point, we need to focus that the sum of the rivers, names of particular persons, places, things, newspapers, which are unique and only one and single, in all these cases, the word begins with a capital letter. So we keep in mind that and follow up the next lesson. Okay.